very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered 5 functions which are based on NumPy arrays. In our today's session, we'll be covering 5 more functions. Let's have a look on what are all these functions. Number 1 over here is a repeat function. Repeat function allows us to create an array where you can repeat the elements as many times as you want. For example, if you want an array of element, let's say 4. Okay, you can use the repeat function over here that you want element 4 and you want it 5 times or 6 times or whatever times in an array. So it would give you an output in this way that it would create an array which will have 4, 4, 4, 4 and 4 in this way. Next is concatenate. Concatenate means if you have two arrays, let's say 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is one array, and if you have another array like 5, 6, 7 and 8. So if you use the concatenate method over here, the concatenate method will join these two arrays along an axis over here. For example, we will get the output in this way 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means it will create a new array which will be joined along with the axis over here. So there are two axes over here. We have the vertical axis and we have the horizontal axis. For vertical axis, we have 0. For the horizontal axis, we have 1. Okay. Similarly, we have vstack over here. Vstack is used if you want to concatenate two arrays along the vertical axis over here. So you can use the concatenate method along the axis or you can directly use the vstack method. Next, we have r underscore statement. It does the same thing that it will join. It will concatenate two arrays along the vertical axis. And lastly, we have the hstack. Hstack is exactly opposite of vertical stack. That means if the vertical stack joins the array along the vertical axis, here our horizontal stack, that means hstack joins or concatenates the two arrays along the horizontal axis. So these are the 5 functions that we are going to discuss in our today's session. Now let's have a look on how we can use it in our PyCharm. First of all, if we are going to use NumPy over here, we will import NumPy as np. Once we have imported NumPy as np, all we need to do is we need to create a variable called as arr. Arr is equals to np dot. We are going to use the repeat method over here. So we will be writing repeat. Now what value you want to repeat? The value is, let's say, 3, and I want to repeat 3 5 times inside this array. And we can define the axis over here. So axis is equals to, let's say, 1. That is horizontal axis, or here actually vertical axis will work. So let's run and see. And nothing will happen because we have not printed it. So we need to print it as well. For that, I'll be writing print arr. And now as soon as we run it, we'll get the output 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. At the same time, if I use 1 over here, it will not work. It will throw me an error. Why it will throw me an error? Because for making it work in a horizontal axis, we need multi dimensions over here. So I'll be giving another dimension. Let's say I'll be writing this and comma 2. So I'll be getting 3, 3, 3, 3, 3 and 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. 5 times. So 3, 3, 3, 3, 3 and 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 5 times over here. And similarly, if you want to put it in a vertical, that means if you want to obtain it vertically, you can put x is equals to 0. And if I run it, now I'll be getting the output in this way that we have a matrix over here. And first two elements are 3, 2. Then again, our next element is 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2 and 3, 2. In this way, we can repeat it by using the x's. So this was our repeat method over here. Now let's move ahead and talk about our another function that is called as concatenate. For concatenate, we need two arrays over here. I'll be writing arr is equals to np dot array, and I'll be giving some elements over here. And then we have another array, let's say np dot, and this one is arr1 actually. So I'll be writing np dot array, and here we can pass more values. Once I have passed these values, all I need to do is use the concatenate function over here. To use the concatenate function, we will be writing cc is equals to, that means you can create any variable over here, and c is equals to np dot concatenate, and here you can pass in a format of a list arr comma arr1. So if I run it over here right now, nothing would happen because I have not printed it. We need to print it as well. So I'll be writing print c, and if I run it, I'll get the output in this way that we have 1, 4, 5, 6 and 4, 5, 6, 7. This is how you can concatenate it. But if you have a multi-dimension array over here, for example, we have, let's say 1, 4, 5, 9. And for it being multi-dimension, I'll be adding one more pair of square brackets. And here also, I'll be adding a pair of square brackets along with one more array over here. So 2, 5, 7, 9. Now if I'll try to do the same, let's see what happens. So it will throw me an error over here. Why it is throwing me an error? Because of the comma. And again, if I run it, so it would join it in this way. It will give me 1, 4, 5, 6, then 1, 4, 5, 9. That means first this element, then this element, then third this element, and then fourth this element. Okay. So we have received this output, that means it is putting it inside the vertical axis. The vertical axis is default value over here, and if you want to put it into a axis of horizontal axis, in that case you can write axis is equals to, and we'll be writing 1, axis is equals to 1 is equals to, we'll be getting the output 1 4 5 6 4 5 6 7. So it is putting it in this way, we are getting 1 4 5 6 from here, and from arr1 we are getting 4 5 6 7. Then again it's joining in this way, that 1 4 5 9, that is the second value, along with it we are horizontally joining what, 2 5 7 9. So this is how it is horizontally joining. And if we talk about vertically joining it, so it will, if we'll be writing x is equals to 0, and it will vertically join it in this way. So if you want to understand the logic over here, let me explain the logic as well. So suppose if we have two arrays in this way, we have 1 2 3 4, I'm just taking random elements over here, and 4 6 7 9, let me just remove the comma from here. Next we have, let's say, 2 3 7 8 and 4 2 4 2. Okay, if we have x, if I have used x's is equals to 1, that means horizontal x's, in that case what we will be getting as the output, we'll be getting 1 2 3 4, that means on number 1 we will get this. Then along with this, because we are joining horizontally, so this value will be joined horizontally over here, and it will come here by 2 3 7 8. So this will be our one array, and our second array would be 4 6 7 8, that means this one. So 4 6 7 8, and this array over here will be joined horizontally to it, that will give us the output 4 2 4 2. This is how our axis 1 will work. If I at the same time talk about axis is equals to 0, in that case it will come in this way, that we'll be obtaining the value as this as number 1, this as number 2, this as number 3, and this as number 4. That means we will be getting 4 different arrays over here, where this one will come on number 1, then this one will come on number 2, this one will come on number 3, and the fourth one will come on number 4. So over here what I'll do, I'll just write concatenate method, and because we are obtaining, first of all let's start with the vertical stack, because we will be doing the vstack and the r keyword. So I'll just print over here using concatenate function. Okay, where x is equal to 0. Now if I'll write print using vstack, for this again I'll be creating two arrays, or we do not need to create, it's already been created. I'll not put the previous part into the comment, and I'll be simply writing vstack. For vstack we'll be taking a variable v is equals to np dot vstack. Inside vstack I'll be passing arr comma arr1, and we will print it as well by writing print v. Now as soon as I run it, I'll get the output. You can see over here we are getting the similar output, 1 4 5 6 1 4 5 9, 4 3 6 7, and 2 5 7 9. Over here also, again by using the vstack function, we are getting the same kind of output. That means if you use concatenate method and you use the x is equals to 0, you'll get the same output as vstack. And similarly if you are using print using r underscore statement, so basically this is the statement, the previous two were the function. So I'll be writing function over here. So for using r statement, all we need to do is write over here, we can write directly print, and we have to print np dot r statement we are going to use, so we don't need to call it. For not calling it, I'll be just writing a list. So because functions needs to be called, so we pass over here parentheses, but here we don't need to pass any parentheses, we can directly write arr comma arr1. And now if I run it, I'll get the output. So you can store it in a variable as well, and I'll be getting the same output, that is 1 4 5 6 1 4 5 9 4 5 6 7 and 2 5 7 9, which is what we are getting with the vstack and the concatenate function using the zero axis over here. So this is what our rstack and vstack do. But at the same time, if I talk about the horizontal stack, that is hstack. So h over here stands for horizontal stack, and if I change the axis is equals to 1 and run it using the concatenate function, we are getting this output. And if I talk about the hstack over here, for that all I need to do is write h is equals to np dot hstack, and here we can pass arr comma arr1, and we'll print it as well. For writing print, we will be using print statement, and print h, we need to print h over here, and as soon as we run it, we'll be getting the output, the similar output that we were getting before, that is 1 4 5 6 4 5 6 7 and 1 4 5 9 2 5 7 9. That means it has been concatenated horizontally now. So I hope guys these all five functions are clear to you, that how repeat works over here, how repeat can repeat any particular element along the axes. Then we have talked about concatenate function, which joins two arrays along a particular axis. After that, we learned about the vstack and the r_statement, which does the same thing that our concatenate do, but on zero axis, that means on vertical axis. And hstack over here does the same thing, but in a horizontal stack, that means in a horizontal manner, it joins along the horizontal axis over here. So I hope, guys, these five functions were clear to you. In our next session, we will be talking about indexing in arrays. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.